Ever since Mary-Jess Leverland made front page news for being the British student who won the Chinese equivalent of the X Factor last year, her first record release has been eagerly awaited. Blackpool TV took along the Filed Coast's very own X Factor finalist Charlese Allen to meet her.
Hi, we're at the Hilton Hotel in Blackpool. Today we're going to be talking to Mary-Jess about her incredible rise to stardom. You've had an incredible 2 years. You've moved to China, you've sung in front of 70 million people.
Yes.
And you've now signed to Decca Records.
Yeah.
So can you actually believe that it's happened to you?
No, I mean, throughout each stage of my journey to this point, there have been things where I've had to blink and look twice and realise that it is actually happening to me and it's not just a dream, if you know what I mean.
Absolutely.
I know that's really cliche, it's a really cliche thing to say, but when you've been wanting to be a recording artist for your whole life, when the opportunity is actually presented to you and it comes along, you can't really believe that it's happening, especially because the industry is so hard to get into.
Absolutely, yeah. So tell us first of all, what took you to China in the first place?
Well, I started learning Chinese when I was 12 because it was offered as an extracurricular GCSE. And so that's when I first realised how much I absolutely love the language. It's so fascinating. And then I decided to carry it on at university because as I said, I wanted to be a recording artist, so I took music, mm-hmm. but I knew that it's a very fickle industry as well as hard to get into, so Chinese was the best backup for me, especially because I loved it, I got on well with it, and the way the economic climate is going, I thought it would be a good option. So I did music and Chinese at Sheffield, and then for the second year we went to Nanjing University, and that's where I came across the show.
Okay, so tell us a bit more about that. How did you come across it?
Well, my friend went to the studio in order to take part in this Takeshi's Castle style game show.
And okay.
I went along for moral support and ended up having an absolutely amazing day. It was hilarious watching him. And while we were there, we got the chance to explore around the huge studio complex. And while we were looking around, we found the studio where the singing competition was taking place.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So the way it works over there is they have, on the JSBC Variety Channel, that's what it's called, they have different singing competitions every week. So the one that I first participated in was for foreigners, and it's just on the afternoon, you get all the contestants and then it's done. Mm-hmm. And then every year they have the huge, massive competition. It's more like the X Factor, where the people who have won previous competitions get to come back, and they also audition around the whole of China as well. So okay. When I was there, I found a producer, found the producer and said, okay, we'll look at getting you on the show, which would initially be for the foreigners competition that I just mentioned. And he said, okay, sing. So I sang Time to Say Goodbye for him on the spot, and he said, okay, we'll get you on the show. So foreigners competition, and then I was invited back for the big one.
So you won the competition, which felt amazing, obviously. And what happened after that?
After that, I was given the opportunity to record a winner's single on a CD. The record industry over there does work differently to over here, because only 3% of record sales over there are actually legal. And therefore, that's probably why Simon Cowell hasn't been over there yet. But I was given the opportunity to record this single, and at that point in my life, it was like everything that I'd ever wanted had just been offered to me on a plate. They were saying, come and record this single, it's been written for you. You can come in and see our producer, and we'll get it on the track and send it out. And I was absolutely over the moon about it. Until I looked at my student visa.
Okay. So what did that mean?
It meant that if I'd have recorded the track and it had gone out and somebody had profited from it, or if I'd profited from it, then the Chinese government would have kicked me out of China.
That's serious.
Because it goes against the terms of my student visa. Yeah. And therefore, if my recording dream hadn't ended up coming true, I would have been relying on my Chinese as my backup for my career. And I don't know of anybody who would hire somebody who can speak Chinese but can't go to China.
So your debut single is Are You The Way Home?
Yes, that's right.
And is that in any way a reference to the competition in China, your coming home
to here? It's a reference to the first few weeks that I spent in China.
Okay.
Because when I got there, it was just such a huge culture shock that I was just trying to look around for things that would make me feel at home in this completely new place. So it's trying to find things that make you feel at home. And the tagline in it has got a little bit of Chinese in that says, Ni shi wo de jia, which means you are my home. And so it's like you're finding things. And China, yes, you can be my home at some point. Like, I will feel at home here. So that's what it is.
Love is
Okay, so the track obviously has an oriental feel. Yeah. But how would you describe your music?
I would describe my music as a true hybrid between classical and pop, with a filmic element and an oriental thread. And basically what that means is that I've been able to take everything that I love from classical music and everything that I love from pop and put it together to create something really unique and really fresh. And the filmic element is in there because film music is there to bring out emotions, and that's what I feel my music does. And then, of course, I've got my story, and so we've included that a little bit as well by including some native Chinese instruments. When we were recording the album, we went out to Beijing for about a week and recorded some instruments, which was amazing. And it was just great to be in the studio and hear my tracks that I'd written being turned into this amazing sound world. So that was absolutely amazing. And coupled with the Western instruments, it's like adding spice to food. You get all the flavours out of it. So
fabulous. So your debut album is called Shine.
Yes.
I believe, yeah.
Yeah.
And did you enjoy the whole album making process and the video for the single?
Absolutely, I absolutely loved it. I think because I had so much creative control, I mean, I co-wrote 7 of the tracks and I had a big hand in the production as well. My producer, Ross Cullum, was an absolute genius, and he was so open to hearing my thoughts, which was really nice of him. So I really enjoyed making the album, and then when it came to making the video, because it was one of the tracks that I'd co-written, I had some ideas for it as well, so it was great that they could be included. So that was great fun, absolutely.
So when will the album be available?
Well, at the moment we've just confirmed that we're going to bring out an EP, so that's really exciting, because what it means is that it's going to be a CD that's available for download, and it'll be in the shops with 4 tracks from the album, so it'll be a really sneaky peek at what the album's going to be like. So now that that's been confirmed, we're looking at a date for the album. But on my website, mary-jess.com, you can get all the information on there and sign up to information emails. So that's probably the best way to find out from now.
What's next for you then?
Well, at the moment, I'm on radio tour, so that's really exciting. It's been a fantastic week, and I get to speak to people like you, so that's great. And my second single will be coming out soon, which is called Glorious. And after that, we'll have the EP and the album, and then I'll be doing another radio tour. So I'm really looking forward to that, and then I get to look forward to my own tour in the future.
So what radio will you be on? Radio 2, 4?
Radio 2, quite likely. Yeah. Hopefully Magic and Smooth and all the BBC regional radios as well. We'll keep our fingers crossed for that.
I think you'll be able to hear me on Radio 2, so I'm sure I'll hear you.
I hope so.
In my car. Okay, well, thank you very much for coming today again.
It's been a pleasure to speak to you,
and
you too.
All the best.
Thank you.
With your single and your album.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks again.
Though I've walked the darkest road, each and every time of cold, you have run to where I fall. Even days when all I feel is tired and without my shield, I know the emptiness will fade. Strong and bright, you stand on the hills above my broken land. Though there's shadows all around me, I know you've already found me. Can't count the many ways you shine.